What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S21 lineup will be launched in 2 months from now on, and hence it's making quite a lot of headlines lately. We have tons of new information about the handset today, starting with some case leaks. Third-party companies have manufactured different types of cases for the S21 lineup. Specifically, we have a couple of folio cases for the S21 and Ultra. Interestingly, it shows the S21 Ultra with four rear cameras, which isn't the case anymore. Samsung has updated the design. Now it will have five rear cameras. You know what those four cameras are gonna be, but still there is a mystery surrounding that fifth camera setup. But it seems we finally know what it could be. Samsung has made ISOCELL Vizion 33 sensor official yesterday, which is an updated time-of-flight sensor that goes toe-to-toe with Apple's LiDAR sensor. This new sensor can assist in AR/VR experiences, as well as 3D scanning and video bokeh effects. On top of that, it has an exceptional autofocusing, which explains why we don't see a laser autofocus sensor in OnLeaks' CAD renders. So even though it isn't official yet, but we can be almost certain that the fifth camera on the S21 Ultra is this ISOCELL Vizion 33D sensor. Moving on, we have specifications of Snapdragon 875 that will go inside the S21 lineup. As per this tipster, who has been right multiple times, the Snapdragon 875 has one ARM Cortex X1 Prime core clocked at 2.84 GHz, three Cortex A78 performance cores with 2.42 GHz, and four Cortex A55 efficiency cores running at 1.8 GHz. The chipset will be built on 5-nanometer process, and reports suggest that Samsung will be making it for Qualcomm. And now it's good news for folks over in the US and Canada that Qualcomm is using Cortex X1 Prime Core for the 875, which offers a 30% performance boost over the Prime Core of the 865. Now this also is good news for Exynos regions because they will get identical performance this time because Exynos 2100 will also use the same cluster of cores as Qualcomm. Samsung might go for a higher gigahertz clock speed for Exynos 2100, and if that's the case then Exynos 2100 will give better CPU performance than Snapdragon 875. Anyway, now that both chipsets are expected to offer similar CPU speeds, the difference will come down to GPU speeds. And interestingly, Samsung might get the last laugh if they go down Huawei's road. Because we have benchmarks of Huawei's latest 5-nanometer chip, the Kirin 9000, and Snapdragon 875, which shows that Mali GPU has finally managed to beat Adreno of Qualcomm. This is from a Chinese benchmarking platform MasterLu, which shows that Snapdragon 875 scored 333,000 on the CPU test, and the Mate 40 Pro's Kirin 9000 achieved 275,000 points. It was expected since Huawei is using a year-old Cortex A77 versus the latest A78 and the mighty X1 cores on the 875. But the shocker is in GPU speeds, as Snapdragon 875 apparently managed to get 342,000 on the GPU test, which puts it behind the Kirin 9000, which achieved 344,000. Huawei even mentioned that its chipset's graphics performance is 52% faster than the Snapdragon 865 Plus, and it now appears that even with the introduction of the new Adreno GPU, it will maintain a lead. Exynos 2100 will also use the same Mali G78 GPU, so Samsung could surprise everyone this time and beat Qualcomm even in graphics. But there's a catch. This new Mali G78 comes in two configurations, one with 18 cores and another with 24 cores. Huawei used 24 cores for maximum performance, but the problem is it consumes a lot of power. The 18-core one is more energy efficient, but doesn't provide the same level of performance as the 24 cores. So we'll have to wait and see what core configuration Samsung is gonna use for the Exynos 2100. In any case, there shouldn't be a performance disparity between the Snapdragon and Exynos S21 variants, which is finally a breath of fresh air for Exynos regions. Of course, let me know what you think about all of this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.